Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about what is a soundstage. I get some questions about this, and sometimes I'm kind of baffled that people haven't heard the term before, especially if they're two-channel people and they listen to stereo music. So let's kind of define it and give some examples of what those of us that are familiar with it know a little bit about. Two-channel stereo to me has always been magical. I mean, even when I was 16 years old and I would take my stereo system from one room in our house to the other and notice how different it sounded because the rooms were different sizes. It's always amazed me that two speakers can produce this beautiful image between them and there's no source there. It's a phantom image, so to speak, but it's always been amazing to me. The process two-channel playback does will leave for another video because it's a little bit complicated, but it's really interesting to see that two speakers can produce that center image that's focused and defined. So we also get, with the center image, we get left and right too. So the goal of any properly set up two-channel system and a properly tuned room is to create that sound stage in front of you, that stage, if you will, where all the instruments are present in their respective position. We can have left stage, right stage, we can have center stage, but in a properly designed room that's treated correctly, we can get a height, width, and a depth. I mean, in my studio in Los Angeles, even though it's only 16, 17 foot wide, it sounds like it's 25, 30 feet wide. So you can actually treat the room to maximize all of these issues that two-channel can produce for you. So our goal in any kind of treatment is a nice combination of absorption and diffusion to produce separation, definition, and what we call darkness. Now, darkness is a really great thing, and it's kind of the ultimate compliment you can pay to a room if it's designed correctly and it has the proper size and volume and ratio of distance to speakers apart, distance to listening position, distance to treatment on the rear wall. So darkness is that quiet space between voice and instruments when the vocals quit, the instruments quit, and the next note is sung or struck. It's that quiet time, that blackness where nothing else is going on. And that's where you have to get the right treatment. And when you get it, it's quite magical. It's actually breathtaking. So darkness is what we go for in both vocals and instruments. What are some of the requirements to achieve all that? Proper room size and volume, definitely. Speaker size matched to the room and things like that. If you don't have any sidewalls, that's probably the ultimate, but most of us do. So if we have those, we have to control the proper rates and levels with treatment in them. So create that soundstage, create that magical place, if you will, and you do have some control over the dimensionality of it, the height, the width, and the depth. But you got to use the right kind of treatment. You got to have the low frequencies managed correctly. You have to have the proper rates and levels of absorption for the mids and highs. And if you're using diffusion, you have to have the right prime number sequence for distances to from speakers to listening position and from listening position to the back wall, side walls, and ceiling. So it's all kind of important. So work on your sound stage. Stay focused on it. Try to move your speakers around a little bit, put them in closer, pull them apart, move them farther away from the front wall, and try to get the maximum sound stage you can that has the height, width, and depth that the source contains. The engineer put it in there. It's up to you to get it out. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis. So that'll help you. Thank you.